When Nintendo created the Switch, they wanted the Joy-Cons to attach using magnets. But there was a problem. The controllers kept falling off. In the end, Nintendo scrapped the magnet idea and went with a mechanical rail system instead. Fast forward nearly a decade, and the Switch 2 is here, complete with a pair of magnetic Joy-Cons. So, why couldn't Nintendo get magnets to work 8 years ago? And how did they overcome that issue for the Switch 2? Let's talk all about Joy-Con magnets. Part 1. Wobbly controllers. Our story starts with the development of the original Nintendo Switch back in 2015. The core idea behind the system was a kind of evolution of the Wii U, which could display games both on the TV and also on a second screen, the gamepad tablet. The problem with the Wii U, one of a number of problems, was that the gamepad wasn't actually doing any processing itself. It just received video from the main console under your TV. But that meant that you could only take the gamepad so far away from your television before the connection would be lost. This time round, for the company's next console, Nintendo would put the guts of the system within the tablet itself, eliminating the need for any kind of bulky console under your television. This new system would be truly portable, rather than the kind of half-step that was the Wii U. Early on in the Switch's development, Nintendo knew they wanted players to be able to connect and disconnect two small controllers from the sides of the tablet, allowing the console to transform from TV mode to handheld mode easily. But in early prototypes of the Switch, the Joy-Cons didn't slide onto the sides of the tablet. They were supposed to snap on using magnets. It was a simple, neat idea. Koichi Kawamoto, the producer of the Switch 2, later explained, "Originally, when we were developing Switch, there was the idea to attach the Joy-Con controllers to the console with magnets. You'd be able to attach and detach the Joy-Con controllers right away, making it easier to share them. But there was a big problem. Unfortunately, the Joy-Con controllers would wobble when attached to the console using magnets due to the weak connection. We decided to scrap the idea, as we were concerned it would make our customers uneasy about using the console." When Yoshiaki Koizumi, producer of the original Switch, discussed this idea in a 2017 interview, he made the problem sound far more dramatic.
"We tried a lot of different things in terms of connecting the Joy-Con to the console, and one that I was particularly excited about at the time was using magnets, where you can just like snap it right to the console." "But as you would play, sometimes it would just fall into your lap."
Nintendo's solution was the rail system. Less simple, but more secure, Koizumi explained. "We still wanted to have something that was sturdy enough for you to hold onto the console, but also gave you that satisfying snap that the magnets did. That's how we came up with the mechanical rails that give you a click." That click sound was so important to Nintendo, in fact, that the Switch plays a sound effect from the console speakers when you slide on the Joy-Cons. It's become an iconic part of the branding of the Switch. And it's a remnant of those original magnetic controllers. The Switch went on to become a huge hit for Nintendo, even without the magnets. As of writing this, the Switch is Nintendo's best-selling home console, and will soon overtake the DS to become the best-selling Nintendo system of all time. But not long after the Switch's release, Nintendo's creators went back to the drawing board to begin work on a follow-up console. And this time, they'd finally bring the idea of magnetic controllers to life. Part 2. Impossible magnets. With the Switch a worldwide success, work began in 2019, 2 years after launch, on the company's next console. Rather than start from scratch and release a console totally unlike the Switch, Nintendo's hardware team decided to instead evolve the Switch concept, creating a so-called Switch 2, which built on the foundation of the original console. This included improving the screen, increasing processing power, a better kickstand, more social features, and a return of magnetic Joy-Con controllers. With years of experience from the Switch 1, Nintendo's hardware team had a better understanding of what makes magnets work and what makes them not work. According to Koichi Kawamoto, "We always wished we could make it easier to attach and detach the controllers, so we asked the Technology Development Department's hardware team the impossible." That impossible request was to make magnetic controllers, which felt firm and stable, but could still be pulled apart from the sides of the Switch 2, even by children or people with weaker arms. Originally, we didn't have the button that would release the magnet, and so you had to pull. And then we discussed, well, wouldn't the kids pull it apart? So my first request was, please use a strong magnet. And the second was, okay, if you want to be able to pull it, please make sure you can pull it. If those two asks sound totally contradictory, then you're not wrong. Strong magnets which don't wobble or shake, but also weak magnets so that anyone can detach the Joy-Cons. Essentially, they wanted magnets that were strong and weak at the same time. Simple, right? But before we get to how Nintendo solved this dilemma, let's talk about how the Switch 2's magnets actually work in the first place. At each side of the Switch 2 tablet is an indent, within which are two strong magnets. And those magnets attract the Joy-Cons themselves, specifically the SL and SR buttons, which are now made out of metal. According to Tetsuya Sasaki from Nintendo's Technology Development Department, the SL and SR buttons themselves are made of metal because they need to stick to the magnet on the inside. And actually, in console development, it is incredibly rare for buttons to use metal. It took a lot of trial and error until we got there. These large, strong buttons, along with the groove and indent on the tablet and controllers, gave the Joy-Cons a strong and sturdy connection to the Switch 2, meaning that Yoshiaki Koizumi's problem with the Switch 1 was finally solved. Many people who've used the Switch 2 say that it feels almost like the console and controllers are one single body, like the Switch Lite. That's how firm the connection feels. So that solved one of the two requests that Koichi Kawamoto gave the hardware team. But what about making it so that anyone, even kids, can pull the controllers off the sides of the Switch 2? Well, that problem was solved in a surprisingly simple way, with a button. All this button does is physically push the Joy-Cons away from the console at the top side, weakening the magnetic pull and allowing users to easily pull them away. No electromagnets or complicated devices needed, just a little lever. All sorts of factors, both within and outside of Nintendo, had to come together in order to bring the Joy-Con 2s to life. According to Sasaki, "There were many advancements made in the world of technology, and we were finally able to get to a place where we could use metal in the buttons." Part 3. Does it work? So, in early 2024, rumours about Nintendo's next console began swirling, at that point with no official name confirmed. One of those key rumours was that this Switch successor would use magnetic Joy-Cons. At this point, fans were dubious. I thought magnets were already tried, tested, and ultimately ruled out for the Joy-Cons in favour of the rails during the development phase of the Switch, said one person. Another wrote, do people not grasp how impractical magnetic attachment is for a device designed to be suspended entirely by those magnets, let alone be swung around and shaken? But as the year progressed, more and more sources put their weight behind the idea that rails were out and magnets were in. In January 2025, these rumours were seemingly confirmed when Nintendo officially revealed the Nintendo Switch 2. In their first look video, Nintendo showed the new Joy-Cons snapping onto the sides of the system, complete with that very same satisfying snap which Yoshiaki Koizumi talked about in 2017. The following month, Nintendo's patents confirmed this for a fact. This game controller is detachably mounted to a body device that has a recess that comprises a first magnet and a second magnet at the bottom of the recess. It was officially the start of a new magnetic era for the Switch, and like I said, everyone who's got their hands on the console has said that these new Joy-Cons feel firm and strong, actually better connected to the console than the rail system from the original Switch, which can get weaker and wobbly after years of use. So, I think this whole process shows off a core trait of Nintendo, which is to never throw away an idea completely. Nintendo tried stereoscopic 3D with the Virtual Boy, then tested and discarded it for the GameCube before finally getting it right with the 3DS. Ideas for Metroid Dread were conceptualized back on the DS before being shelved and finally brought to reality in 2021. The Switch's magnetic Joy-Cons follow a similar pattern. Magnetic controllers didn't work in 2017, but Nintendo held on to that idea, and now here we are, almost a decade later, with the company's big new console starring magnetic Joy-Cons. If at first you don't succeed, try again. So, when you snap your Joy-Con onto your Switch 2, remember, it took Nintendo nearly 10 years to get that snap right. Hey, thanks so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. Videos like this are made possible by my Patreon supporters, including Aaron and Catherine, Brett and Eric, Candy Crystal, Cyprian Eov, The Real Procyon, Daryl Gero, Ellie Birnbaum, Elise Rose Barsness, Eliza the Doe, Jim Gilsonen, Kieran Chan, Kelly Wright, Kick to Cosplay, Lucas Little, Michael Gunter, Preston Kerth, Skatorpie, Thomas Söderlund, and Tlazot Lalia.